What's going on, everybody? My name is London. Thank you for watching my YouTube channel. This is gonna be officially my first video. My page is definitely to enlighten and inspire. It's gonna be totally definitely different, you know, than what you've seen before, but I mean, this is just what it is, you know. So make sure that you guys do follow me right here on Instagram, and make sure that you just comment, subscribe, and do all of that good stuff. On all of my videos, I want to make sure that I feature all independent artists. So with this particular song, shout out to my homie Lucky Ya Dig. This is her song that is entitled For Us. I was actually the director and the DP and the editor for this particular project right here. But yeah, man, shout out to Lucky Ya Dig. It was a great song. I still bump the song today, you know what I'm saying? So yeah, shout out to Lucky Ya Dig, and you can find her information right here. I had the pleasure with going down and being a part of the Stud 2 lead panel. Shout out to my guy Belinda Drake. Met her last year in Atlanta. See, this is what happened when I gotta sit my ass still. Hey man, anybody wanna buy me a camera, girl? Bang, buy me a camera, girl. Bang, that's my address right here. Bing! If you fuck with a nigga, buy me a camera. I forgot to mention that this was my second time being invited to this. Shout out to Teresa, though, from Stud Model Project. You know what I'm saying? She was on the panel last year. All love, all the time. First off, let me dust my shirt off. Like a hating bitch, hate off. Think straight, just eliminate what they try to break when they try to break. Sick of these bitches trying to come for me. Kissing ass, trying to sit in my company. Well, this past last weekend, I flew out.
The doors are closing. Please keep clear.
You know, and basically, this is just a recap.
I'm glad it's nice. Holy light from the sun would not burn me. On my palm when I shake the moon,
I jump the moon. So, boom. Some of the topics that I just kind of want to clarify would be... I wrote this shit down too. You know I don't care no more. I be stuttering with a whole microphone.
I don't know who I'm yelling at.
Yo, shout out to all the panelists, yo. All the panelists, for sure, for sure. You guys are amazing. You guys are definitely an inspiration. And it was just a pleasure being able just to share the stage with some empowering women. So just real quick, I'm just gonna kind of run through some of the questions and the topics that we did discuss and just share with you kind of my perspective. All right, so boom. When you say stud or when you put people in a box, it's hard to live, to thrive.
Hey man, shout out to the studs with heels. Studs with heels. Studs with heels. Studs.
We have to stop putting and placing all of these constrictions and restrictions and these rules on people and humans and sexuality and fluidity, because that's what a human is. We are less than perfect. There is all error. And I feel like that's why we have so many sexually suppressed people that are in that category of being labeled stud. You have so many people that are depressed, suicidal, just because they feel like they have to live up to the things or the expectations that we place on a masculine identified woman in the black community. Now, I don't know who wrote the rules, but I'm not a part of that system, that box. I am Kristen Jordan London, and that is the only title that I will obtain. Am I a masculine identified woman? Absolutely. Am I feminine at times? Absolutely. Am I masculine? Absolutely. And I'm proud of both of those dualities. You don't have to place yourself in this box. If you want to wear baggy clothes and then tomorrow wear makeup, you go do that. You know what I'm saying? Just make sure that you are the person that we need for this world. Can studs have a baby? You can do whatever the hell you want with your vagina, okay? The only thing that I will say is you have a social and moral responsibility to yourself and your community to make sure that you are able to bring a life in this world that is an asset and not a liability. We have enough badass kids in this world. We have enough children that need to be adopted and that need love. It's so much more than the maternity shoots, and it's so much more than the gender reveal parties. And then they also ask, what type of girl are you looking for in a relationship? Her own independent entity that is completely in love with herself. And I'm not saying that she's consumed with herself. I'm saying that she's in love with herself. So the only thing that she can do for me is not give me time or money, because I can provide those things myself. I need her to give me something to love, give me something to honor, give me something to support, and give me something to be inspired by. Whatever the case may be, she gotta make me a better person.
See, you need someone like me to satisfy your every need.
It's my notes. It's the same thing that I was doing on the stage too. I was like, these good notes. I don't care. Ooh, good notes. Yeah. Ooh. And I don't shave my underarms. I think that it's cool to normalize non-violent conflict resolution, normalize budgeting, normalize respect, normalize manners, normalize financial literacy, normalize entrepreneurship. Immerse yourself in the struggle and the hustle. I think that it's okay to be uncomfortable and put yourself in uncomfortable positions. It's so important and it's so critical to growth. Accountability is special. If you keep on, oh dang, sorry, that's not you being accountable, that's you being sneaky. Yeah, so yeah, basically just turning your problems into solutions. Being accountable is cool. Normalize accountability. Joe, sorry.
Yeah, stanky leg, 2020. What's up? Hey, NapTown don't give a damn.
I don't know. I think that it's very important, very, very, very important, whether you're a studs who lead, whether you're a femme that leads, whether you're a giraffe that leads. I just need you to lead people into the right direction. True leadership is not about being in control or in power over other people. True leadership is literally empowering the people who are following you. You know, fake leaders, it might look good, smell good, but it ain't good. And you're gonna go down a dark, lonely road of self-hate, judgment, and destruction.
Bow, bow, bow. Hey. Well, shout out to that hoe. She was cool. Hey, boy, NapTown get down for sure.
Again, shout out to NapTown. Shout out to B. Drake, okay? Get married. Congratulations on your engagement. I was able to be all up in y'all's business. When I was flying over Indianapolis, I was just looking at how red that state is, but how much history is there.
Because like, that's not in the history books, though.
Exactly, but it's coming out. Like, there was one article, like, one like, really ancient article that was published in one of the first black newspapers that was here in Indianapolis. Now, resurfaces really kickstarted this whole movement because it was lost. Like, the college that was placed in the exact spot that was placed at, it was one of the most thriving black communities. You know, it was making it seem like they were
affordable housing, right? Lockfield Gardens, mm-hmm. Well lived.
And they was making it seem like that, like, we're great for Indianapolis, we're building a college, like, this is gonna be wonderful. And it was just like expanding.
Expanding, taking down these neighborhoods. You gonna drop me off in the back?
No, I can't
drop off. You gonna drop me off in the back?
No, I
thought we progressed.
You
gonna leave off in the front now?
No, I just messed it up.
It was like me though, that one time I went to the dentist and they took me to the back room because of social distances. I was like, well, I gotta go to the back. Like, everybody's spaced out. I had to calm down. Niggas be sensitive. This year has been something else. We literally went through hell to get a black female vice president.
Even though B. Drake wasn't crowned senator, she's still making moves. She's making an advancement to turn that red ass state blue. Shout out to everybody and every masculine identified woman that is courageous enough to lead in all the places where we're not supposed to.
Hey, I don't know who the DJ was, but you were lit too. I'm a dude. VIP. That all Drake song. And it was free drinks all night. What's up, NapTown?
Of course, my stupid self missed my damn plane. I had my lawn shirt going down. I looked like yesterday, bro. Wanted to take a shower and get time. But she changed my ticket.
Oh, damn. I'm looking at the wrong thing, but whatever. Okay, I'm gonna get it later. I hope y'all dig the footage. You know what I'm saying? I got some more stuff coming on the Reggie Deggie Deggie Deggie, but subscribe, like, comment, and do whatever you want to do. Hit me up.